Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I am 35 today, weeks pregnant. I was gonna try to do weekly updates as of like 32, I think, weeks. I missed 33, I missed 34, so much has happened. I am super tired lately. I have two boys, so I'm busy with them, their school schedules, so just a lot has been happening. So yeah, so I'm 35 weeks pregnant with a surprise gender baby, if you guys haven't not caught that already. Hi. Of course, as soon as I start recording, everybody wants to come in. Okay, so as of my 34 week prenatal appointment, I weighed 164, which is a total gain of 25 pounds. My blood pressure was good. The baby's heart rate, I think it was like in the 130s, and then it, like, the baby got excited and it went up to like the 140s and up to like the 150s even, like, as she was checking the heartbeat. I'll mention this real quick. At my 34 OB prenatal appointment, actually that morning before I went to that appointment, I had an appointment to do some lab work for my husband's work for like our insurance thing. And so they did like an extensive like list of things that they were gonna check in my blood. They called me and said that my blood sugar was lower than they would like, even for being pregnant. So it was at a 59. So the nurse from my husband's work is the one who called me and, you know, was telling me that that was kind of low. All right, so the dog was barking because UPS came and dropped off my Amazon welcome box. So maybe before the video is over, I'll open this up with you guys. We'll take a look at it together. Okay, so getting back to that. So my glucose levels was a little low, 59, more than what they would like for it to be, even being pregnant. So she just kind of was like, you know, make sure that you're snacking. You don't go too long without having a snack or having some food in you. She asked me if I had been feeling tired or dizzy or weak. And honestly, I have been feeling really, really tired lately. Like, since that week that I did all that stuff, like the blood work and all that, like that whole week was really draining on me. And I just thought it was because we were busy. But even like on the weekends when we didn't really do much, I just felt super exhausted. Like the second that I started like moving around. So I have been trying to just snack a little bit more, drink more juices, stuff like that. I did tell my doctor about it, and she's not too worried about it. She said that if it continues, by the next time that I go see her, that she'll look into it and maybe have me do some more blood work to see where my level is at then. I do see her on Monday, so if within the next, what, like 3-4 days, if it continues, then I'll bring it up. If not, then it could just be one of those pregnancy symptoms that, you know, you just kind of have to deal with, and you just happen to be tired, you just happen to be, you know, super thirsty, which I think those are all pretty common in pregnancy and late pregnancy, you know? I've been feeling really winded lately. As you can tell, I'm already like, it's hard to catch my breath. My stomach has been feeling, for one, super itchy. For two, I have an area like where it's really tender, like on the left side of my belly button, where I don't see that there's a stretch mark there. Like, that's not the reason why it kind of feels tender, but like, just feels like a cut, like it's wanting to like cut open, like the baby wants to like just bleh, like cut its way through my belly. Like, it feels like very tender at times. Like, even when I'm moisturizing, it just feels like very sensitive in the area, almost like a burning, like tear feeling. I think it's just because of like my stomach stretching. I don't think it's anything super serious, but I have been feeling that. Sciatic pain is constant all day, every day, not just in like my butt and like hip area, but it's even going towards the front of my leg as of like the last like 2 days. Like, if I'm walking, like, I don't even feel it sometimes in my back. It'll just be like in the front of my leg, like in the front of my thigh. So I have to be very careful of like when I'm walking and I feel it. I'm constantly getting stuck on the floor because if I get down and play with the kids or pick up something, I'm stuck. Like, that pain is just right there and it stays for a couple seconds and it's like, I can't move. Like, I am stuck here with this pain. I've been feeling really heavy and I've been feeling really slow. I feel like I walk very slow. I feel like getting off the couch, getting off the bed, even sitting down to the toilet, getting up from the toilet, like, everything is just starting to be very uncomfortable, sometimes painful, especially when the baby's moving and I'm trying to like flip sides on the bed or on the couch or move a pillow or something. It's just, there's a lot going on in this area. The baby hiccups a lot now, probably a couple times a day, and I would say it's every day, and I'm even starting to like feel it in my butt, like in my butt area. I feel hiccups. Like sometimes too, I'm like, oh my God, please don't tell me that you flip, because I'll feel it like more like above my belly button, but I don't know if it's maybe like if it's laying sideways or if it's laying like a certain way that I feel like the movement of like the hiccup feeling, just I feel it up higher too. Or maybe just because it's a small baby, and if it hiccups, it kind of moves the whole body. So you kind of feel it everywhere, but for the most part, I do feel it like down below, like in my pelvic area or in my butt area, which is, it's really weird. Like, especially when you're sitting and you feel those little throbby like feelings. It's really weird. I still do have some slight swelling in my hands. I don't know if you guys can really tell. It's not a lot. And yesterday was the first day that actually, like, I did not want to struggle with trying to put my my ring on and off. So I had gotten out of the shower and I noticed that like it just didn't want to go in like as smoothly. So instead of like struggling, and I kind of feel like, well, if I'm having like that minor swelling now, I might as well just leave it off, just because if it does end up getting worse, and I don't want it to be stuck on my finger. So I'm not wearing my ring as of right now. And it's not like, you can see, it's not like super, super swollen. They're not like super pudgy or anything. And then even my feet, like, they're not that bad. I don't know if you guys can really tell, but like they're not that bad. Like, oh, I can barely lift up my feet. They're not that bad. I still see like my bones. I still see my ankle and stuff like that, and like my little tendons or whatnot. My astigmatism, I feel, is getting worse, which I did hear is common in late pregnancy because of your hormones and all that stuff. So I have been wearing my glasses more often, which they 100% do help me see a lot clearer. And I know I should be wearing them more often anyways, even when I'm not pregnant, but I can't get used to like the frame part, especially when I'm driving. Like, I don't like wearing my glasses because I feel like I see so much frame, and maybe I just need like a pair of glasses that has like a lighter frame. But I don't like wearing my glasses. Heartburn has been horrible lately, mostly all day, every day, or at least a few times a day. I have had heartburn, like really bad heartburn, to where like I'm so hungry, but yet I have to wait because I already feel the heartburn, and I'm like, I can't eat while I have the heartburn. So I take, you know, the Tums and stuff like that. Honestly, they don't always work for me. Laying propped up doesn't always work for me, but it's like sometimes to the point where it's like right up here in my throat, where I'm like, gosh, like this heartburn, like it really sucks, and it feels so horrible. Like, I don't like it. And as far as like being active and like, you know, going on my walks and working out, I honestly have not worked out in the last 4 weeks, almost a month maybe. Like, here and there I'll do like some squats, I'll bounce on my ball and do like some stretches, but I haven't actually done like a workout routine. And a lot of it is because I'm starting, like I said, I'm feeling really tired or just hurting. Like, my body just hurts all the time. As far as like my emotions go, like, I'm not like emotional or anything, like I'm not like sensitive, but I do feel that I'm starting to stress a little bit because I feel like this baby is gonna come very soon, and I feel like we're still a little bit unprepared. Even though I'm trying not to stress about that, there's a lot going on with my kids. Their school schedules, my youngest one just started preschool, so I've had a lot of appointments, meetings, evaluations. There's a lot of stuff that we had planned to get done before the baby comes, so it's mainly just like the frustration, I guess, of something not getting done when we thought we were gonna do it. Just a lot of little things too, like even just around the house sometimes, like I don't want to clean, I don't want to move, I don't want to do a lot of things. So then I get frustrated that I'm not able to do those things that I normally do. The dog sometimes get on my nerves. Our oldest dog keeps having accidents inside the house. So again, having to get down, bend down, spray, wipe, all that stuff, it's starting to really bother me because I'm physically not able to do it like I used to. So I think one of the biggest challenges that I'm having right now is that my body is definitely extremely pregnant and extremely hurting, and I'm not sure how to handle that because I'm a very active person. I'm you know, on the go early in the morning with my kids, getting stuff ready for them, playing with them, hanging out with the dogs, being outside, and then still being a wife, having, you know, time for myself, like, which I honestly, I have not had any time for myself. I'm almost done reading my hypnobirthing book because lately, like the last couple nights, I've been telling myself, you need to read more. You need to just spend more time on yourself because this baby's gonna come very quickly, and then I'm gonna feel like like I didn't do anything that I wanted to do before it. Like it was more of like stuff that we needed to get done and not like just relaxing and enjoying the last couple weeks before we have baby, which is what I really, really would like to do in these next 5 weeks, less than five maybe, who knows. But I do have a girls' day on the calendar for me and my best friend to hang out. We're gonna go out, have lunch, hopefully take her with me to do my Target like baby registry shopping, because I have my coupons ready to go, so hopefully we can get out before the baby comes and just spend a little bit of like just chill, relaxing time. Yeah, so that's pretty much what happened on my 33 34, and then now that I'm 35 weeks, like I said, I see my doctor on Monday, so I'll do like an actual like 35 week pregnancy update for that appointment. Just go over some of the things that we talk about at that appointment, and then if there's any new symptoms, then I will talk about those on my next bump date. If there was something that I missed out or something that I should have mentioned and didn't, or if you guys want to know something, please leave me your questions in the comments section. I know somebody did ask if I was gonna do, it was like a belly cast or more maternity pictures. Honestly, I've never done a belly cast with any of my kids, so I probably won't do one with this one. As far as maternity pictures, if I find a day that I'm able to relax and get ready or have my kids, my dogs, my husband, then we might just do something little, not anything, you know, over the top. Oh, I forgot to mention, my hospital bag is almost done being packed. So if you guys want to see what I'm packing for the hospital for me, baby, and possibly my husband, Robbie, he probably won't be there too long because I told him once I have the baby and we're situated, you can just go home and hang out with the kids. But if you guys want to see what I'm packing, let me know in the comments and maybe I'll just do like a short video of what we're taking to the hospitals. But yeah, other than that, let's go ahead and see what's in here. So this is, I got like a, I think it's called a baby registry welcome box from Amazon. So basically you just created a registry, you're a Prime member, and then you had to have bought like a $10 item from your registry or something. Oh, and then you have to complete like the checklist of every category, and honestly, like I didn't need everything in that category. I really don't need a lot because I have a lot still from my last two pregnancies, but in order to get like the welcome box, you had to like just go through and complete the checklist, so it doesn't really take a lot of time. Oh, I already see stuff that I like. I like these bottles. I have used these for both of my sons. This is the Avent, a 4-ounce natural bottle, and they're little. They're so little. Some sample draft, which I'm not going to use this time, actually, but it's good to have just because it's good to have extra if you run out or whatever. I did the Arm & Hammer Clear and Free, I believe, for the babies, all like the baby's clothes, which is what we use anyways, and my kids don't have a sensitivity to it. It also doesn't have as much fragrance as this stuff does, so I don't think it's gonna harm the baby. Water wipes, like a little travel pack. Honest Face and Body Lotion, I do like this. I have used this before for the boys. Breast pads, which in the past, guys, I've never needed breast pads. They've never leaked out to where I needed to put something to absorb. But I have a lot of samples of that now, so maybe if I need to, then I'll have them on hand. I think this is, yeah, I got this one in the Target baby registry gift as well. So it's just like a little pouch, cute little pouch with, I believe it's a diaper or two. Oh no, there's more stuff in here actually. Coupons, there is another draft sample. There's a travel pack of baby wipes, and then a, I think this is either a size one or a size newborn Pampers. Oh, can you guys see that? Diaper. Oh, this is cute. Oh, little zebra muslin. Can you guys see that very well? A zebra like little swaddle. So that's cute. This is a full size, so that's pretty awesome. And that's pretty much it. Not too bad. And before my camera dies, because it's starting to beep at me that my battery is low, I'm gonna show you guys my belly. These pants, guys, have gone through three pregnancies. They are starting to rip. I don't know if you guys can see it right there. So there is the belly, front, side. Thank you guys so much for watching my 33, 34 week pregnancy update. I hope you guys enjoyed it and stay tuned for the next one. Ciao.